Hello, I'm Chini, a struggling indie game developer. Today, in my 5th Jerboa Devlog, I'd like to talk about the greedy meshing algorithm. Now, before I explain what it is and how it's used, I'd like to set up the context for this devlog. Collision detection and response in Jerboa is implemented using object-based collision, for the lack of a better term. That means the terrain and walls in the game are actual game objects with memory allocated for its positions and scale, among other properties. I could have looked into implementing tile-based collision, but for this project, I chose to not spend the extra time to write the new collision system. From this point on in this devlog, I will refer to the objects as colliders. When building the levels, I still very much rely on Gamemaker's tile map system. The colliders are then generated based on this tile map. Initially, I opt for the naive approach of creating a tile-sized collider per solid tile in the map. That means for a tile map like this, more than 300 colliders will be created. For most part, that is fine and dandy on PC, but a lower-end mobile device may have trouble running such a level smoothly. Especially if the level also contains multiple enemies. This is in need of optimization. And the solution is to, instead of making 300 plus colliders, make instead fewer of them at different sizes in such a way that still properly covers the tile map. The algorithm to do so, as I've learned, is called the greedy meshing algorithm. Here's a step-by-step demonstration in a visual manner of how this algorithm works. The red circle represents the top left corner of a new collider. Once the red circle lands in a valid tile, the blue circle will then start moving as well. This blue circle represents the bottom right corner of the collider. It will keep moving to its right until it can no longer do so, then proceeds downwards. Eventually, when it could no longer move, we then create the collider at the desired position with the desired size. We continue the above steps until there are no more tiles left to process. As we can see, we have gone from over 300 colliders to just 8. I'd say this is a pretty nifty algorithm. Having that much fewer colliders means that collision detection is no longer the performance bottleneck, and I can now direct my attention elsewhere. And that's all I've got to share for this short devlog. I hope this has been helpful, and I'll be back again with more to share about the development of Jerboa. Thank you! If you've liked what you've seen, consider giving this video a like and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you very soon!